What? Let's go. Let's go. It's my birthday. It's my birthday. It's my birthday. Bless new day. Bless new day. I will be 53. Later on today. Today is my Earth Day. Just one more day to be thankful. Oh my goodness. This past year has been amazing. So I have wonderful testimonies. I also have, you know, things that happen, you know, in relationships and family and stuff like that, that have been very challenging. But what's been amazing is my ability to transmute it and to enjoy my life, regardless of people acting crazy or not. You know what I'm saying? They're going to do that. Haters going to hate. Crazy people are going to act crazy. So, I'm who I am. I'm owning all of my energy over here. And my energy is great. And I've had a blessed experience in the past year that I'm very thankful for. Yeah. So, I didn't really want to, like, go out of my way to spend a lot of energy to do something, you know, grand, because in reality, I enjoy my everyday life. There's no environment that I enjoy more than my own, because I set it up for myself to enjoy. You see the length. These are artworks that I've created myself that I put on my walls, you see. I'm going to make prints of them. But I love them so much, I'm not going to sell them. They're like my temple pieces, you know? So, yeah. I can't go anywhere where I'm surrounded by crystals like I am in my own home. Or like, you know, I always am burning incense, and all of my favorite things are here. So, I've decided to have a really chill day. I'm gonna make some blueberry banana hotcakes for myself with some really delicious eggs, and I'm going to later on have my favorite spaghetti. I haven't been eating spaghetti lately, but spaghetti is like a staple for me. When I lived in Africa, in Ghana, we would eat spaghetti every Sunday, and it was a very big deal, because we had a house gal. We had a woman who worked in our house. She wasn't a woman, actually. She was young. I think she came in when she was like 17. She worked in our house, and she would make meals the other 6 days. So on Sunday, she was off. And so that's when I would cook spaghetti. And it's because they really didn't have ingredients to cook most of the things that I would cook normally, you know, like she would cook the ground nut stew and the fufu and banku and inkati and kwine is ground nut soup. You have kakran kwine, which is when they put a little, it's a vegetable soup. Okra stew. I learned how to make some of these things, but they were pounding fufu and stuff like that. So yeah, and we had two people who worked for us. So they would cook the food every day because I was working with my ex-husband and homeschooling my children. Yeah, but anyway, spaghetti was a staple. I am a spaghetti expert. As far as the way I like my own spaghetti, it's perfecto now. And the thing is also that I had started eating meat. When I turned 50, I started eating meat. And I ate it like during certain times, and I started, you know, using it. You know, like related to the collagen and all that kind of stuff. It's like I didn't want to get pills more than I just, like, I'll just eat a hamburger, you know what I'm saying? But Spirit's telling me to stop. Even though I know it was good for me at the time, I need it because I hadn't eaten meat in like 20 years or something, 20, 30 years, like as far as beef. So I think it was good because it was a good injection at the time. But now I'm not going to be eating meat the same. Maybe just fish. I don't eat chicken again now again. I'm going to eat seafood still. But anyway, but not often. So I picked up soya again, which I haven't used soya, but I know. As I was a vegan chef, my soya tastes like pepperoni meat. Okay. I am so proud of myself, to be quite honest. Pepperoni is the best flavor ever. That is what makes people want to eat meat. For me, it's like, man, pepperoni. The flavor of pepperoni. I know how to make the flavor of pepperoni on my soya. And how to get it the right consistency of meat. But not hard. But I do it. Okay. And then I have my mushrooms and my zucchini. Do not play with me. Organic spaghetti sauce. This is the way I treat myself. I eat like this normally, but I haven't had my spaghetti in a long time. Like the las titayas también. Like no one can make my spaghetti like I make my spaghetti. So I'm treating myself to that. But I'm also going to be taking a different walk because I want to see a hacienda that's nearby. I might go hang out there for the day to take a swim. And do a little photo shoot. You know, I'm looking like my normal self, but I want to just take pictures of my normal self. I don't need to put on makeup and lashes and, you know, get my hair different. I'm just going to take a photo shoot as me. Like I like to do. As my butterfly self. Mariposa. Yeah. I'm not against makeup and stuff. If I had it available to me, the kind that I like close by, I would use it sometimes, you know, not every day, definitely not. But there are makeups that are like moisturizers that are like, you know, just add a little glow, a little bronzer or, you know, and even out everything. Sure, I'm not against it, but not necessary. I do have the oil. I do have healthy things to put on my face, but I don't have color, and that's okay. I don't want it. Let me be the representative for the older people who look good at our age, and we don't have to do all that. You know, I don't have to do all that to be beautiful. You don't. So this is the theme for today. Don't hate me because I'm beautiful and intelligent. Okay? Because being beautiful ain't enough. And so we will talk about that later. All right. I'm headed out on my walk. Later. Don't worry. You know, I'm really enjoying coming into this park. I never come here, so it's just, you know, something new. That's the thing, is I always have the the excitement of being a tourist, even though now, you know, it is home. It's been home, so I feel very comfortable. And I know it on a deeper level. I don't, my interaction with the place is not like a tourist. However, las detalles, me encanta. It's like, there are a lot of things that are like Los Angeles because of the Spanish architecture, right? So, yeah. Me encanta. Mi experiencia aquí. You see this here? This here is a plumeria tree, and I know how to replant a piece, so this is a blessing. Yay, winning for my birthday, a white and yellow plumeria tree. I love plumerias. And you can re-sprout these. I'm excited. So those are classic cars. It says museum. This is where I'm headed. I was like really about to start filming from the outside. I'm like, oh, this is where I'm coming. Yes, I'm excited to see what it has to offer. Una hacienda. Traditional. Yeah, so I just wanted to try something new today because it's my birthday. It's my Earthday. It's my Earthday, not my unbirthday, which I also celebrate, but my real authentic revolution around the sun. And here I am at Hotel Hacienda Sanchez. Let's see what's going on over here. It's beautiful. Hacienda Sanchez. Yes. And whenever you come in from like Merida or from a lot of different places, you'll come in on this road. So I've seen it many times from the outside and said, what is that? And now I'm just like, let me go and see what's going on. Look at these beautiful images. That's a tall bird right there. A tall bird. And that is a hummingbird, colibri. Mm-hmm. Yes. Look how pretty everything is. Look how pretty the grounds are. And this is the restaurant. Lots of typical Yucatan. I love paintings, so. Oh, wow. Okay, let me take a picture of this, because this is very interesting. Okay, the Catholic Church under construction. Okay, let me take a picture of this. So I've lived in Valladolid for 4 whole years. I have never seen anything like this on the wall. So I am very happy about it. I'm all about the revolutionary history. Valladolid was actually called Zaqui before the conquistadors, you know, forced them to change the name to Valladolid, which is also the name of a city in Spain. This is the kind of information that's very difficult to find in Valladolid. If you go to the bookstores, they don't have any detailed information like this. So, it gives you a very accurate idea
of how violent the history was to the culture of the Mayan people.
In the restaurant area, this actually is an image of Valladolid.
It shows how they deconstructed the pyramid in order to create San Servacio, church in that is adjacent to the main park.
Dismantling the pyramid to make the church with the stones from the pyramid. I've been looking for this information. Oh my God, this is crazy. How disgusting. Oh my God, I am blown away by what they're saying about Candelaria 2. Listen to this. The population of Valladolid was hit by a smallpox epidemic in the mid-1800s. They all fled their faith in the Virgin of Candelaria. Disappearing evil. And they considered it a miracle when it went away, and so that's why they made it the special day of Candelaria on February 2nd. Listen, Candelaria is the Black Madonna, but they don't talk about that and they don't make her black. But they sought refuge in her. Listen, I'm like, this is the kind of stuff the history that I have been waiting for. Okay, I already knew that Candelaria is the Black Madonna. She's Yemaya, the same day that they honor her in Brazil. Anyway, I'm gonna get into it, but yo, this history is so deep to me.
So yeah, happy birthday to me, because this is what it's all about. Here's some other images that are very, you know, nice, but the whole Black Madonna thing, that's cray.
We know that history, right?
Oh.
Oh, they must have covered up someone's face or something. I love how historical this place is. Look at this, this is a safe. Back in the day, isn't that cool? And that's an old radio that's all broken down, but I appreciate it. Very cool. Beautiful paintings. I'm gonna go over all of them.
So yes, it was a very unexpected surprise. I really enjoyed going back into history, and I will be addressing the Black Madonna and Candelaria in another video to give it its just due, okay?
Look at that. Oh, how pretty.
Okay, it's official. I'm coming back. I love this place. This place is awesome. And the food is awesome. Oh yeah, we're about to have a whole day over here.
excited. It's very beautiful. I'm gonna be right back. Yes, Casa Sanchez. I'm gonna come back ready for my butterfly photo shoot. I love it. Okay, so this is their Museo de Autos, the car museum. Okay, it's very humble, but let's look at it. I think it's great. All right, the Ford 1930 Forito. All right. Wow. Oh my God, that would be so fun to ride in, wouldn't it? That would be so fun. And with my hair, it would be like blowing in the wind behind me with the green. Oh, don't play with me. Yes, what's the next? Okay, it doesn't tell us what it is.
And that's okay.
Oh. That emblem on the front. Let's look at it closely. This. Look at that. Wow, that's something, right? And then this too. That's a detail. Very inside. Wow. Very impressive. Oh yeah, so beautiful. I love the style of these old cars. They trigger me because they remind me of slavery, but like I like to think of myself as having fun. I guess I'd have to identify with my white ancestors to do that. And I should do that, right? As far as being able to tap into the freedom. Fun. Look at this. Oh my God. This also says Ford. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? And then from the front. Oh my gosh, a butterfly just got on me. How nice. Ford. Look at that. That's awesome. Just the work. And then look at this one. Oh, what is this, a Carmagia? Oh, so cute. And the colors. Oh, wait, the inside is pink? Oh my God, that is funky fresh right there. Whoa. Let's see, what kind of car is this? Huh, I don't know this one, but it's beautiful, right? Oh, this one is so cute. Take it for a spin, you know what I'm saying? Yes. This one too, that one's big. Look how long it is, oh my God. It goes all the way, it looks like a hearse almost. Is it a hearse? I don't think so, but it's a Dodge. It says it's a Dodge. Look at it. Wow. Oh, the color. The color alone wins for me as far as why I love this one. This one is beautiful. Beautiful car. Yes. I know that emblem means something. I'll have to ask my friend. Oh, it looks like a slave ship and a pirate. A ship. Okay, I'm going to return. I have to go get my bathing suit and get beautiful. I will videotape the rest later. But oh yeah. I love old cars.
the style of them. That's what it is, the style. You know? They really feel like works of art, whereas now they feel like capsules. Right? Don't go for this idea of, you know, modernizing to this whole idea of the future. The future can look like whatever we want it to, and there are aspects of the past that we can embrace and bring it into our future. So yes, I embrace classic style, baby. How pretty this is.
Up when the sun comes up.
Bump, bump, ah!
Yes, it's raining. I love it when it rains. I have no problem when it rains. Who has problems with water? Don't we wash every day? Well, you know, I don't wear makeup and I don't have anything in my hair that would be disturbed. So, it's libertad. It's very important. I remember when I was in college and I first started wearing my hair natural. It was extremely liberating to not have to even think about it, to not run when it starts raining, because I love the rain. I'm one of the children who used to put on my rain boots and go jump in the puddles, you know what I'm saying? So I don't, not the one. Yay. I have two plantas now. I can't wait. A gift from Espiritu. These things are expensive.
yeah, 53 is awesome already. And what I realized is that, honestly, I just make my own fun. I can go anywhere, I can do anything, and as long as I'm with me, I'm gonna enjoy it. It was a simple day, yet so profound. And I really couldn't have asked for more. It was perfect. So thank you. Since it started raining, I didn't go back to go swimming, but I did return on another day, and I will have to show you that video another time. Actually, I went back twice. So I look forward to sharing that with you, Kaleidoscope Klan. And I encourage you all to make the most out of every day. Enjoy your birthdays and your unbirthdays, because every single day is a gift, and we should never forget that. Never take this beautiful life that we're living for granted, especially if you are blessed enough to have ears that can hear this, eyes that can see this, and to have a body that's in good working order. I am infinitely blessed, and I look forward to seeing what this next year is going to have in store for me. So until next time, Kaleidoscope Klan, continue to embody the sacred transformation. This is Mariposa Ma'at, and until next time, peace.
Introducing my first published book.
Oh, yeah!
To be a butterfly, the caterpillar has to die. Poetic expressions of transformation from the cocoon. Yes, after 5 long years of cocooning in the Mayan jungle, I've finally emerged and earned my wings. And just like the title says, this dark night of the soul wasn't always pretty. Within the 144 pages of this epic work, you will find 30 passionate poems that are sure to be thought-provoking, stimulating, and even triggering at times. Welcome to my world. Buy your copy now on Kindle.